Biggie Smalls for mayor, Biggie Smalls for mayor, Biggie Smalls for mayor, for mayor, for mayor. They tell me bad boys move mighty silently. Finally, I'm glad I know of notoriety. I always have these mixed emotions deep inside of me, but privately I shed a tear for him surprisingly. Biggie Smalls was always like the crook you should avoid. Way before when he was up in Brooklyn as a boy, he would have been an STD if pussy was a choice. It's just I doubt that he was who you're looking to exploit. You wanted to be mayor, that might have been enormous. You might have had somebody dress up as a Sasquatch for it. He was a little gloomy, he was a little morbid. You often felt it when you heard a record he recorded. Biggie didn't really get along with Mother Mary. Like Bible school was something too detestable and scary. I'm sure he didn't like the little house on the prairie, but you could have wrote about his charm in the obituary. He's in the cemetery, but there's a lot we live for. Biggie Smalls was somebody who gave a little more. I don't know how buddy-buddy Biggie is with Satan. All I know is I would like to eat Flapjacks and Bacon. And if Christopher Wallace wants to make my homeless placement, maybe we can have some breakfast and a conversation. I don't know how buddy-buddy Biggie is with Satan. All I know is I would like to eat Flapjacks and Bacon. And if Christopher Wallace wants to make my homeless placement, maybe we can have some breakfast and a conversation. I hope he isn't filling any shit in the balloons wherever Biggie went, cause that would spell some certain doom. He's got a lot of making up for things I would assume, cause Biggie was a bad boy since he left the womb. This rap Alfred Hitchcock used to tell a tale, and left a lot of other rappers following his trail. He might have took a saloon to sniff him out like Chip and Dale, and what you got from him, somebody who wouldn't fail. Did he put him on? He knew him that it's Puffy. He really misses Biggie, and the song he wrote was lovely. Biggie used to say, until they kill you, you're nobody. But I remember him and begging him to be their Teddy. Apparently, he used to beg to sleep on the couch. But maybe Biggie didn't want to act like a grouch. I'm sure that Thug's bitch, where the dude is hanging out, might now may come around if you can offer sauerkraut. Biggie Smalls should know that little kid has built a shrine. I'm sure she prays to him and he should give her a sign. I don't know how buddy-buddy Biggie is with Satan. All I know is I would like to eat Flapjacks and Bacon. And if Christopher Wallace wants to make my homeless placement, maybe we can have some breakfast and a conversation. I don't know how buddy-buddy Biggie is with Satan. All I know is I would like to eat Flapjacks and Bacon. And if Christopher Wallace wants to make my homeless placement, maybe we can have some breakfast and a conversation. Finally, we have to talk about these allegations. The statements that he made when he was acting like he's Satan. I see a lot of rappers do it and they're all mistaken. Even if they're acting evil just for entertainment. His name was Christopher, and Christ is in the name, which tells me that he must have known that they were much the same before he started acting like this shit wasn't a game and giving everybody reasons why they should complain. Cause Biggie Smalls was definitely someone worth a look and make your heart beat like a Sasquatch foot. Many rappers drink the backwash that he took, but it doesn't take a crackpot to know he was good. He wasn't really good, I guess that he was wicked. Even if it's also safe to say that he was gifted. He talked about butt-fucking when he really got explicit. I wonder if we ever could have had him any different. I don't know how buddy-buddy Biggie is with Satan. All I know is I would like to eat Flapjacks and Bacon. And if Christopher Wallace wants to make my homeless placement, maybe we can have some breakfast and a conversation. I don't know how buddy-buddy Biggie is with Satan. All I know is I would like to eat Flapjacks and Bacon. And if Christopher Wallace wants to make my homeless placement, maybe we can have some breakfast and a conversation. I don't know how buddy-buddy Biggie is with Satan. All I know is I would like to eat Flapjacks and Bacon. And if Christopher Wallace wants to make my homeless placement, maybe we can have some breakfast and a conversation. I don't know how buddy-buddy Biggie is with Satan. All I know is I would like to eat Flapjacks and Bacon. And if Christopher Wallace wants to make my homeless placement, maybe we can have some breakfast and a conversation.